Welcome to St. John the Evangelist, the oldest and most vibrant Catholic community in Baltimore County, Maryland. On behalf of Father Pete Littoral, our pastor, and the entire parish staff, we want you to know that you are welcome, loved, and prayed for. The COVID-19 pandemic has affected all of us. At this time, please take a moment to pray for all those who have died from this deadly virus. For much more information about all of our ministries and ways to stay connected, please go to our website, www.sjehides.org. Again, that is www.sjehides.org. May God bless us all.
Good morning, and a very special happy Mother's Day to all of our mothers. At this time, we'd like to present a very special prelude dedicated to all mothers, featuring one of our cantors, Jasmine, singing the most beautiful and sacred setting of Ave Maria by Franz Schubert. Thank you.
Good morning. Good morning and welcome to the celebration of the fifth Sunday in Easter. Our celebrant for this liturgy is Father Pete Littoral, our pastor. For those that may be interested in fully participating in the music for this liturgy, our administrator has posted a link in the comments section. We encourage you to fully participate in the prayers, the songs, and all the rites of this most sacred liturgy. Please stand and join in singing our opening song, Sing a New Song.
Welcome again to St. John the Evangelist Church community here on Long Green Valley. Today we are going to celebrate three big things. First, we celebrate Mother's Day, and we greet all the mothers who are celebrating with us in this celebration from the sanctuary of your homes. Also, we celebrate Nurses Week. We give thanks to these frontliners who've been helping us. And we pray for all mothers, for all nurses. I'd like really to especially pray for all the Filipino nurses from Maryland and Washington, D.C., who are joining us also in this celebration. And we celebrate our great encounter with the Lord through the proclamation of the Word and through the Eucharist. You are not only watching, you are celebrating with us. Let us begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of God our Father, and the love of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, Jesus' words in the gospel today assure us that he is with us as the way, the truth, and the life, but also challenge us to live as people of light and truth in a world marred by the darkness of sin. So to prepare ourselves for the Paschal feast of the Eucharist, let us pause to give thanks for God's mercy and forgiveness in Jesus. Lord, Lord Jesus, who is the way to the Father, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ Jesus, who teaches us the truth, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, who leads us to everlasting life, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God in the heart.
Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may under your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated, and we are now going to listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men filled with the Holy Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was acceptable to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit, also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing the refrain to our responsorial psalm. taken from Psalm 33. Our response is, let your mercy be on us, O God, as we place our trust in you.
Let your mercy be on us, O God, as we place our trust in you. Let your mercy be on us, O God, as we place our trust in you. Your words, O God, are truth indeed, and all your works are
from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in Scripture, behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith, but for those without faith, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, a stone that will make people stumble and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be
to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading is taken from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If they were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than this, because I am going to the Father." My dear friends, this is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The gospel says to us, giving us this blessed assurance, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. My dear friends, permit me to begin the short reflection from the first letter of St. Peter, reminding all of us who we are in the eyes of God. For this is the grace of this week. As we celebrate Mother's Day or Nurses' Weekend or Nurses' Week, we celebrate an opportunity for us to encounter God in the word that was just proclaimed and in the Eucharist, reminding his presence with us. St. Peter, in the second reading, invites us, come to him, he says, a living stone rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. Peter is talking about Jesus. Just like last week, the gospel reading invited us to enter the gate of the sheepfold. John was talking about Jesus, our good shepherd. Brothers and sisters, I believe on this fifth Sunday of Easter, the Lord is providing us this wonderful, blessed assurance. Especially during this time of pandemic. Because the Lord encourages, the Lord assures that we will never be alone. I believe there is no greater assurance than what the Word of God is telling us about us. Clearly, in Jesus, we are called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a consecrated nation, a people the Lord claims for his own, to proclaim the glorious works of the one who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. So the gospel begins, do not let your hearts be discouraged. Do not lose your heart, especially on account of what we are experiencing right now. For today is an opportunity for us to encounter the Lord. For Jesus himself speaks to us, invites us, come to him. You are a chosen people, a people of his own. We are precious in the eyes of God. You may feel at this time of pandemic so much distress, so much burden. You may feel so distanced from God or alienated from him or from someone. We discover through our interaction in our human family at home, during our shelter in place, so many things that may be discouraging. The Lord is inviting us to come to him right at that moment when we feel so low and so down. Because the Lord reminds us, reminds you and me, we are chosen people, and we are precious to God. Many of you may be wondering and questioning, why are we so precious? Why do we remain precious in the eyes of God despite what we have done? Well, just look at your family. Look at your children. Why are your children so precious to you? Is it because of what they do? I don't think so. There are many times, of course, that you are proud of your children for their accomplishment, but you love them even without their accomplishments. Remember, when your son or daughter was just a baby. When you first held her or him as infant, as baby, you could not believe. You had so much love in you. Yet the baby did not do anything. Why do you love your baby? You love her or him for who she or he is, not for what he or she does. Your child is your love for your spouse. Now a unique person loving you back. You see, God's love in your child. You see a reflection of God's beauty in your child. So going back to God, to the question, why does God still love you? Well, clearly, He loves us for who we are. We are a unique reflection of His love in the world. He loves us because He sees in each one of us the love for His Son, Jesus. He loves us because each of us carries on the life of Jesus in the world. Reflecting on this, truly our readings this Sunday establish the fact that we are important cornerstone. We are important to God. We are important cornerstone to our family, to our faith community. We are living cornerstone, just like our Lord Jesus Christ dwelling and living in our lives. And I hope and pray that you have already realized, for instance, that you are a holy priesthood. Now, during the shelter in place, mom and dad, you're leading your family to prayer. You invite and sometimes nag your children to come, at least in this live streaming mass. Now you see that you are carrying on the priestly presence of the Lord, making God present to others, especially during this time of pandemic when we feel we are isolated. You can lead all to prayers, shepherding each one to God. I believe no one can question who we are in the eyes of God. We are precious to God because He sees His Son at work in us. And as a pastor, I always make use of this reality. The counsel that I always offer to people is, attune to your dignity as child of God. And the way to do that is through Jesus. The very reason why for so many weeks God and the Word of God is inviting us to come to Jesus, because He is the way, the truth, and the life. Just like what the gospel reminds us, we are precious to the Lord, and through Jesus, we can become what God created us to be. We are precious to the Lord, and we have the responsibility to show that to our world right now, to your family right now. Now is the time to hold our heads up through the muck of society, through bad times or challenging times like this. Now is the time to have enough self-respect to avoid degrading ourselves by giving in to what everyone else says to us. Now is the time to stand tall with the Lord, for we are His people. We are His church. We are the royal priesthood. We are the people set apart from whom God has chosen to bring light to others. We are St. John. I pray that during this pandemic, your choice will only be that which reflects the dignity of who you are and have been gifted with by the Lord of life. Amen. Please rise, and we are now going to profess together our faith by reciting together the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered there and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, a giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As a chosen race and God's own people, let us now offer prayers on behalf of all in need as we all respond, Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, the temple built of living stones of faith, and its leaders, may its life always be marked by prayer and service to those in need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation and all in government, may they work together for the betterment of all our citizenry, keeping in mind those whom they serve. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For St. John Parish, especially Father Pete, our principal, Mrs. Blake, for all staff and teachers, facilities team, our volunteers and benefactors, may God richly bless them in their devotion to our parish and our school. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering from the COVID-19 virus, those who are ill with any malady, and those who have been adversely affected in any way because of the coronavirus, may Jesus, through the intercession of his mother Mary, provide them healing, comfort, and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all nurses who provide care for the weak, the ill, the vulnerable in homes, healthcare facilities, and hospitals, especially those on the front lines during this pandemic, may God grant them a respite, comfort, stamina, and hope as they go about their life's work. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers, for godmothers, and for those who are looked upon as motherly figures, especially those who are missing their children and grandchildren.
May our Blessed Mother intercede on their behalf and grant them wisdom, gentleness of heart, comfort when they're weary, and joy in their vocation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those listed in the parish book of prayer intentions, and those who struggle to find purpose and meaning in life, may they find their remedies in listening to the voice of the Lord, who is the way. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially our mothers and nurses, may they live forever in the Father's house, in the place Jesus has prepared. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Nora Dahl Feely, and for all mothers for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. In your house, O God, we long to be with you and your Son, who reigns in glory. Do not let our hearts be troubled, but hear us and help us to follow the way set by your Son, that we may live with you as you promise. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please join in singing our hymn for the presentation of the gifts. Hail Mary, Gentle Woman.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. May the mystery of this water and wine may we come to share in the beauty of Christ. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite hearts, may we be accepted by you, Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, away, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me of my sins. Pray now, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to load you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now coming together as one God's family, let us now pray together the prayer that our Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of Christ's peace. Peace of Christ be with you. Peace of Christ be with you. Peace of Christ be with you. Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. For our prayer for act of spiritual communion, you may just follow together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And before I do the final blessing, because today is Mother's Day, I would like to do a special prayer and blessing for all the mothers. And I would like to ask all of you, if you are at home, to pray and raise your hand and pray over your mothers. Good and gentle God, we pray in gratitude for our mothers and for all the women of this world who have joined with you in the wonder of bringing forth new life. You who became human through a woman, grant to all mothers the courage they need to face the uncertain future that life with children always brings. Give them the strength to live and to be loved in return, not perfectly, but humanly. Give them the faithful support of husband, family, and friends as they care for the physical and spiritual growth of their children. Give them joy and delight in their children, to sustain them through the trials of motherhood. So most of all, give them the wisdom to turn to you for help when they need it most, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And before I do the final blessing, once again, I would like to thank all of you for joining us in our celebration of the fifth Sunday of Easter. And I want to thank most especially to all our friends and benefactors, families of St. John who donated casseroles and food items last weekend. It was a record-breaking response, and it speaks highly of the goodness and generosity of St. John family. And next weekend, we have a special collection for Haiti. Since you are not able to come, please just make an envelope so that we can support our sister parish in Haiti. You may mail it to us or drop it off at the parish center. And if you have a need, please contact us by phone or email. We send daily communication for all our parishioners. And always please check our Sunday bulletin on our website. Check our Facebook and Flack Notes email. We thank you always for your continual support to St. John Parish. Although our buildings are closed, our staff continues to work to provide online programming, sacramental preparation and faith formation, and daily communication. We understand that you do as well, and your financial resources may be affected by the shutdown. And for those of you who have been affected by this, we have you in our prayers. We are grateful for the many things that you have been providing. As you come to St. John along Long Green Pike, you will see new things being developed on the campus of St. John. Last Friday, we just planted hedges along the fence so that we can prepare the campus for our bicentennial celebration. And always remember, we pray for all St. John parishioners every day. And I say my daily masses for your intentions. And we continue express our gratefulness to this team that have been helping me, providing you the live mass streaming so that we can celebrate, not just watch, we can celebrate the holy sacrifice of the mass every Sunday here at St. John, 9 o'clock in the morning. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow your head and ask for God's blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his beloved and only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. Amen.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen. Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen. Amen.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us now go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
As we are sent forth to live our mission to go and make disciples, please join us in our closing hymn, Alleluia, sing.